Hello everyone, it's MJKTV here, and I'm gonna play Super Mario Bros. 1. Ooh. I'm not that good at Super Mario Bros. 1. I'm pretty good at it. I got to World 4. No, actually World 3, I think.
I bet they killed her. I bet she's dead. I'm right around the middle. It's a weird thought, but once again, I don't know what it's like to go through that grieving process. So possibly this is what their process was, and it's weird to us, we're little outsiders.
Said that in what he remembered in December of 1910, a man had a bomb named Benoit, asked for help from him and another man that some reports of him
little old man. He's on suspicious or like the star of the moon.
Buried the woman under a concrete floor in the basement and was paid $250 for his involvement by a well-known man. There has been some speculation that the man who paid Lenoris could have been George Crisco, though there's no hard evidence to support this.
Bad dudes, if your friend comes up to you and says, I need a favor, help me move a lady, and you're like, yeah, sure,
into her apartment?
No. Oh, no. She is unconscious. Gotta move her.
After Lenore's confessed to helping bury the woman thought to be Dorothy, a team of detectives searched a home matching Lenore's vague description on April 21st, 1916. When they got to the basement, the team was surprised to find an area of the concrete floor that appeared to have been broken up into the past. The area, however, was small, about 5 feet by 6 inches, and the caretaker claimed the floor had been broken to fix the gas line. The authorities returned a couple days later with the owner's permission to dig up the spot. They indeed found a gas line. Within the year, authorities were satisfied that the horse's claim to be false. The third and final theory we're discussing today is that Dorothy accidentally died during an abortion. In April 1914, Pittsburgh home of one Dr. C.C. Meredith was raided by police. Meredith, his nurse, and another doctor, one H.E. Lutz, were all arrested. The home was used as a private office where women would come seeking abortions. Lutz made a statement to the DA that at one time, Meredith had told him to be honored at one of his patients. When Meredith spoke of her, Lutz inferred that she had died and her body had been cremated in Meredith's office. While Lutz didn't admit to seeing Dorothy himself, he did testify that he witnessed another young woman who died in Meredith's care.
Oh.
In the raid, detectives did find two oversized furnaces in Meredith's basement. There's speculation that Crispin could have been who had impregnated Dorothy, but evidence of this, or of Dorothy ever being in Pittsburgh for an abortion, is scant at least.
Just two quick things about that. One, even back then, women didn't have control over their bodies so much that they would have to go to the So this may be more for just a wild public imagination.
There is circumstantial evidence that maybe this happened, but what if the person who was arrested is made?
Sorry if the camera's not that good. I'm holding the camera with my legs, so. That's me. Oh. Okay. So, I'm gonna try, Super Mario Bros.
Two. Anyways, check out Dancing Drew on the CW. It comes out on October 9th, Wednesday's this month. She could have solved this case, I think. I think she could. She's certainly better at it.
Which I'm gonna try Super Mario Bros. Wait 1 second. Wait a second. Nintendo Switch difficulties.
A case that has been referred to as, quote, the number one unsolved murder case in Texas history. And, yeah, I love it. I don't think they have, like, a big board in the Texas police station. It seems all relative. But they seem pretty resolute about this guy being.
Super Mario Bros. 2. Can I skip them? Kinda takes a while to open the door. I forgot how to open the door. Okay. See you later. Whoa! So I was trying to hurry up. Wait a second. Come on. I hate climbing up here. Ah! Get out of my way. That's the end of my video, MJKTV. Well, subscribe if you want to. See you later. Bye.